Alrighty guys, so I am off to a doctor's appointment. We found like the most amazing doctor. Well, we didn't find it. It was just kind of dropped in our laps by God. But it's so funny because over the years we have really like we found all these herbs that really work for us. And apparently we have found like the Illuminati of herbalists, I guess. They're all connected. They all kind of know each other. So, but it makes me feel really good to be like, yes, we have. We're onto something because the herbs have really helped. Anyway, yeah, it's just been kind of cool. But anyway, I've been having just a really, there's a lot of ice on the road. Okay. I've been having a really, whoa. Okay. All right. Okay. I've been having just a tough month. Just, you know, I had a very big personal loss and, I'm putting this out there because I feel like I should, but I'm putting it on like a sacred tab, so I don't know when we'll find it until much later. I just really wanted to talk about like, you know, life after a loss because it was so funny. You know, I was thinking this morning about the things that sell, and the things that sell are like happiness, like soapy bubble happiness that just kind of pops in, you know. Tragedies because I love my romances. And you know, like I am a lover, I am a like a warrior poet, you know. And what's hard is that for, you know, I was thinking about like this argument that I was kind of having with God because I was like, I'm so practiced at just kind of having joy that I can't even like really be as sad as I would like to be about certain things. It's like I know I'm going to have to take time to grieve, and I really, like, I pre-grieve everything. It's like, you know, I think about, like, you know, as soon as I meet people, I'm like, what will it be like at their funeral? Like, I have to kind of, I'm always preparing myself for the worst, I guess. I don't know. But, anyway, I just have a mentally tough time with grief.
Because I hate loss, and I hate change.
To lament, and I felt like God was like, okay, go ahead. I was like, are you gonna watch me, like, are you gonna look over my shoulder as I lament? And he's like, yep, go ahead. And I'm like, I would like to lament a love lost and loves that are lost, you know. And if one love is lost, then all loves are lost. And I felt like it was like he said, and if one love is found, are not all loves found? And I was like, yes. I cry over one love that is lost if all loves are found, you know. And I was just so frustrated because I was like, oh, it's so true. Like, you know, at the end of the day, you know, heaven wins, and I know what the end of everything is. At the end of everything is happy and joyful. And so it's like, why waste my time being down about stuff? And it's not that you shouldn't feel an emotion when you feel it. Like, you know, Jesus, you know, he cried even though he raised Lazarus from the dead like a few minutes later, you know. But because death is sad, it's fundamentally sad, and death and separation and loss, those are all things that happen because of the fall and sin, and they weren't supposed to be, you know. And I think that, you know, Jesus was a man of sorrows, and he, you know, out of everybody, he really knows what it is like to lose a love, because he loved the whole world enough to die for it. And then he has people just felt like, oh, he really gets it. He really understands. It's like, you know, I was talking with someone the other day, and they were like, well, doesn't God, like, want you to kind of, they didn't use these words, but, like, kind of be happy or, like, do things out of the goodness of your heart and then just kind of, you know, what exactly were they saying? It was about, like, you know, kind of living more for this world. And there's just, if this world is broken, you know, this world is very broken and there is beauty here. And that's what they were saying, is they were saying, like, why don't you just enjoy the beauty here? And I do. I really do. But there is something here in this world, in our bodies, in our hearts, in our minds, you know, that's broken. And it just, it leads to a lot of sadness. And that doesn't mean that we don't have joy. We do. And we are more than conquerors because of Him who loved us. But it doesn't mean that it's not hard. It doesn't mean that it's not sad. But at the end of the day, you know, I know the end. I do know the end of the world is, you know, post-apocalyptic world is actually really wonderful. You know, it's not all sadness, because Jesus will come back and He will fix everything. You know, whether that's now or later, or who knows, but it doesn't matter, you know. And even just in death, it's like, I will see Jesus, and I will be with Him, and there will be no more death or crying or pain, you know. Anyway, I just thought it was kind of funny, because it's like, it's this dual thing where it's like, you know, life is often sad and, you know, things are broken, but in the end, I can't really spend a lot of time just being sad about it all the time, because it's like, there's so much to do, you know, and if you know the end of the story, the end of the story is good. You're not as upset, you know, but anyway. Yeah, and even just the things, you know, because I am such a planner, and it's like, you know, after this loss, I'm like, okay, I have things I need to do, worlds I need to conquer, and then it's like, I felt like God was like, that's still you doing your thing, you know, you have to be listening to what I do and what I say. And there's this verse that says, the Spirit is like the wind, you know, it blows and you don't know where it's going to go. And life with God is so not religious. It's completely outside of the algorithms, because you just don't know what He's going to ask you to do one minute to the next. And that can be really, really hard, because you want to put down roots and you want to be like, this is my life. This is what I do every day. This is my routine, you know. But God keeps us youthful and free, because we're not really supposed to have a routine, you know. So I think that's kind of, I don't know, I think that's just kind of interesting. And we don't belong to the world really in any sense, you know. We don't belong to the material world, being bound down by just stuff. We don't really belong to the world in its the way that it does business, or the way that it does its systems. We just don't belong in that way. And people, you know, they might see you doing something and they might be like, oh wow, you seem to have all these answers, come sit with us and tell us what you have. And really, you have to be like the wind, you know, because as soon as someone tries to pin you down, like, the thing that's keeping you going is the Spirit of God. And so to have that, like, let me sit and tell you all the things that I'm doing. It's like all of a sudden the wind goes out of your sails, because it's not you. It is the Spirit of God. And I was thinking about that, and it's like, oh, you know, because I'm such a teacher. I love to teach. That can be a real downfall, because you can have a lot of pride, you know. And so I just, at this point, I'm like, you know, I'll say things that God wants me to say, but I don't want to be a teacher anymore. I just want to do what He asked me to do. And, yeah, so it's going to be a good year, but I really do want you guys to be in on my, my process of letting things go, because I'm not perfect, and I want everybody to know that it's okay. It's okay to fall apart sometimes. It's okay to not have good days, but at the end, who is good? God. Alrighty, well, have a wonderful day, and I'm off to the doctor's. Hopefully my mascara won't run. Alright, bye!
I'm really good at this now. So I have tears inside my eyes. My mascara has not run. And normally I have, like, a tissue or something. I don't think I have a tissue, but hold it. Oh, one ran, but it comes You gotta get it to fall down directly. No run, we're good.